Hey guys, in this video I want to give you a little bit of insight into how I structure full body workouts. Before I get into that topic, guys, I encourage you to check out my new book called Massive Iron. It is linked below. It is a base building system that will help you build as much muscle and strength as possible during your first several years of training. If you're not satisfied with your results, please check out Massive Iron. It'll help get you up to speed. Now, what I'm doing here is I broke out the whiteboard. I want to show you guys exactly how I structure full body workouts. Some of the workouts in the full body workouts in my book Massive Iron use some of this structure, so I want to explain it a little bit. Excuse me, I have a little bit of a cold, so if I look or talk funny, it's from that. So let's talk about full body workouts, and I'll show you how I structure them. A typical full body workout is 3 days per week. Most full bodies like starting strength or strong lifts or the classic full bodies are structured with Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So I'm going to use that structure. I'm going to list workouts under Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. It really doesn't matter what days of the week you work out, as long as you have a day of rest in between each workout. So for just the sake of organizing this or structuring this, I'm going to use Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So let's start with the big hitting exercises. It is very popular with some of the strength type programs like strong lifts and starting strength to squat 3 times a week. I typically don't structure my full body workouts with squats 3 times a week. What I'll do is this. I'll put squats on Monday, squats on Friday, and then deadlifts on Wednesday. Now, I don't necessarily think you need to squat 3 times a week. I'm not saying programs where you're squatting 3 times a week are ineffective, far from it. I just like to see more recovery. I like to see trainees squatting on Monday and Friday. This gives a little bit more recovery time, and it allows us to squeeze deadlifts in on Wednesday. There's no point in deadlifting, in my opinion, multiple times per week. It's counterproductive. So I like to put the big hitting exercises in this type of structure. Now, you could do rep work on Monday. Sometimes I'll structure full body workouts where you do rep work on Monday, like 3 sets of 5 or 3 sets of 6 to 8 or 3 sets of as many reps as possible. Close to failure, but not at failure. You don't want to train to failure on squats, obviously, but sometimes I'll use a rep goal system, which is detailed in the Massive Iron book, and set a goal for 25 reps for 3 sets. In any case, you can either do rep work on both days, Monday and Friday, or you can do rep work on Monday and say a 20 rep squat set on Friday. Those are two common ways I structure squats in the context of a full body workout. So, back to the program. I have you squatting twice a week on Monday and Friday with deadlifts on Wednesday. That's the starting structure I use for most of my full body workouts. Now after that, we get to other major body parts: chest, shoulders, and back. Let's just look at the upper body, the torso, major body parts. We have chest, shoulders, and back we're going to squeeze in next. Now, I like to, because chest and shoulders are both pressing, pressing muscle groups, you're utilizing a lot of the same muscle groups. You're utilizing some of your chest or upper chest, delts, triceps, etc. So what I like to do is I like to put in a chest exercise. Then I like to break up the chest and shoulders by putting a back exercise in between the two types of pressing movements. So I'm going to show you what I typically do. Let's just go with Monday, and I'll put bench press here, okay? Instead of moving on to your shoulders, I want to use a little bit, I want to give your pressing movements a little bit of a break, your triceps and shoulders, give them a little extra recovery time. So what we'll do here is we'll squeeze in, let's say pull-ups, okay? And then I'm going to put in one arm, dumbbell, overhead presses. So what we have here is we have the bench press, which is primarily a chest movement, but because it's a compound exercise, it hits your shoulders and triceps as well. We have one arm dumbbell overhead press, which is a pressing movement that involves a lot of the same muscle groups as a bench press. The shoulders, the front delts, perhaps some of the upper chest, etc. So in between these two pressing movements, I inserted a back movement, pull-ups, just to allow for a little extra recovery time for your shoulders and triceps, etc., before you tax the same types of muscle groups. So that is how Monday, a typical structure I would put for a Monday in a full body workout. Now, on Friday, okay, I like to change up the type of exercise you're going to be performing. So on Monday, you have bench press for chest. On Friday, I want another heavy hitting exercise. So I'm going to put dumbbell incline bench press. Okay, so we have a bench variation, but it's different. It's still a compound movement, but instead of barbell and flat bench, we're going to move to dumbbell and incline bench. Wednesday, I'm going to put more of an isolation or machine type exercise in, just for a little extra recovery, for more of a light but still muscle building type of day. What I would recommend here is either something like pec deck or machine chest press. So what you have here is your chest work 3 days a week. You have a heavy hitting compound exercise, a compound variation that's a little bit different, and on your Wednesday you're still hitting chest, but you're just doing so with a more moderate type of exercise like pec deck, machine, machine chest press, dumbbell flies, cable crossovers, anything that's still challenging but a little bit less taxing than your compound movements. Now, for back, on Wednesday we have deadlifts hitting back. On Monday we have pull-ups hitting your back. And on Friday, what we're going to do is we're going to put a row variation. For this workout, I'm going to put barbell rows. Okay? So we have three ways of challenging our back during the week. We have pull-ups, deadlifts, and barbell rows. So those are all in there. Now I'm going to, let's look at shoulders. Right here we have one arm overhead shoulder press. Over here I'm going to put military press. That's the big hitter of the week. You can really put any overhead press variation you want. Over here we have a variation on the press. And on Wednesday I'm going to put a lighter shoulder exercise. Because this isn't press heavy, it doesn't really matter what order you put these in. So I'm just going to put side lateral raises. Okay. It doesn't really matter on Wednesday here when we're putting more moderate variations, and like I said, because they're not press heavy. The side lateral raise is not press heavy. It's not going to overwork your triceps. The pec deck or machine chest, chest press will, you know, work your triceps, but not as intense as the bench press and one arm overhead press or incline bench press and military press. So it doesn't really matter the lift order on these days. It's not essential that we separate these two to allow for a little extra shoulder and tricep recovery. Now what I'm going to do here, if you see there's one hole in this this programming structure right now, and that is legs. We have squats here, we have squats here, but we have no leg work here. So what I like to do on Wednesday is sneak in the leg press. Where you put the leg press doesn't matter. You can put the leg press after deadlifts, or you can do deadlifts, have a couple light exercises like pec deck and side lateral raise, and then move on to leg press. It doesn't really matter. So what we have here is we're hitting the major muscle groups out of the gate. We hit the legs, the quads, the chest, back, shoulders. We have those on all 3 days right now. The only thing we're really missing is hamstrings. Now, I will say that I do, I don't typically program hamstrings in 3 days a week, and here's why. Squats typically hit the hamstrings rather hard, and you're already working them twice a week. Deadlifts will hit your hamstrings hard. So when I program in hamstrings, what I do is this. I put program in the stiff leg deadlift or Romanian deadlift, and I also program in leg curls. Now I like to put the stiff leg deadlift over here on Friday. You're doing deadlifts, then you have a day of recovery, then you have stiff leg deadlifts, then you have two complete days before you hit your hamstrings again. And over here, we're going to put leg curls, okay? So that's more of a moderate hamstring exercise. You get a day of recovery, and then you're hitting your hamstrings indirectly again with deadlifts, a day of recovery, and then stiff leg deadlifts. I like, personally, to do the dumbbell stiff leg deadlift variation. I find it, more engaging. It's more of a fun exercise for me. It really doesn't matter which, variation you use. So that's how I structure my hamstrings. We have squats, dead squats, leg curls, and stiff leg deadlifts that really hit the hamstrings each week. And in my opinion, for a full body, that's plenty. Now what I'll do to balance this out is I will sneak in calves. Okay, so we have five exercises on each day, and you're hitting calves on the middle day. And you can train calves more than you like, if you like, you can train calves more than this. This is just a basic structure I like to use. If you need to train, what I do recommend when you're training calves is that you focus on getting them as strong as possible. You can do seated calf raises, standing calf raises, etc. You could also do a trap exercise here. Now, even though you still have, you've done deadlifts, you can go back and hit your traps with like power shrugs, and then you could stick in calves here and here if you want to get more training. You could put calves in, and then maybe you could stick in a forearm exercise, or you could stick in extra ab work or whatever. So there are many ways you can structure this. I'm going to go back to the original structure I put in and just put calves. Okay? Now we are left with everybody's favorite muscle groups, the arms. What I like to do is train arms 2 days a week on full body. Okay? So over here you might do skull crushers. Over here you might do rope cable tricep extensions, rope extensions. You could have, for biceps, dumbbell curls. And for here, rope curls. Okay? So we have seven exercises. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we have seven over there. You hit the major muscle groups and arms. We still need to hit abs. So you can sneak in some ab work here. You can also sneak in some trap work. So what we have is I like to create a balanced type of routine. How you balance it doesn't really matter. The key thing to remember when you're trying to structure a full body workout is you want to get the major body parts balanced. You want to get the squats, the legs, the chest, the shoulders, and the back. And after you do those, you can really structure the minor body parts any way you want. When I make workouts that show ab work only once a week, some guys simply don't like that. It makes them uncomfortable. They feel like they have to work their abs more than that, which is, really not necessarily true. Your core is getting worked hard with squats and deadlifts and, single arm overhead presses. I would do planks here. I would do ab wheel rollouts. Stuff like that. That's plenty for your abs. You can squeeze in more ab work after this. It really doesn't matter, like I said. But this is the basic structure. Hit your major body parts. Hit your major body parts. I hit arms twice a week. I hit hamstrings twice a week. And then I find a way to fit in calves, your ab work, and maybe traps. If you don't want to train traps, you know, if you feel you're getting enough work on your traps from deadlift, you could do forearm work, you could do more ab work, you could do more calf work. You could also do, put in rear delts if you feel you need rear delt work, etc. The rear delts are typically hit quite, effectively with pull-ups and rows. Those are all motions that are very similar to reverse fly. So you can even squeeze those in if you want here. And you see, as far as exercise balance, now we have more exercise on Wednesday. You could balance that with more ab work or more calf work, or really, whatever you feel is lagging or necessary. Or, you just want to do a fun exercise, that's okay too. So this is the basic structure I use for full body workouts. This is how I wanted to help, show you guys a little bit what my thought process is when I'm creating full body workouts. There is no perfect workout. You need to keep that in mind. But there are some mechanics that make sense when you're structuring a full body workout. If you want to do squats 3 days a week, that's fine. There's ways to do that as well. Maybe in future videos, I'll show you how I would structure a workout like this, a full body workout with squats 3 days a week. But this is a basic structure I use. Squats, dead squats lead off most of my workouts. Typically, I'll do reps or pause squats here, recommend reps or pause squats here, and rep or pause squats here, or even a 20 rep set of squats. So guys, I hope this video has been of some help. If you have any questions or comments, there is a link below to a forum Q&A. Come on over, ask me any questions you want on strength training, muscle building, diet, nutrition, supplementation, or motivation. I also ask that you please check out my new book called Massive Iron. You'll see some programs like this in Massive Iron. If you're unsatisfied with your muscle and strength building results, Massive Iron will help you get up to speed, build as much strength and muscle as possible. So guys, as always, thanks for watching. Have a great day.